Sorry, I'm
Hey.
all over the place tonight. My kids are having meltdowns, and it's just one of those nights. I had two kids crying
Oh,
the last 5 minutes. So
I'm so sorry.
Times over here.
I had to.
Okay, let me see. Make sure there are not people waiting.
I'm not in my house right now.
There's no waiting room. So it's like the last few weeks. I've not done anything different. It's exactly the same. And there was a waiting room. And I was like, what's going on? But anyway, there's no waiting room tonight. That's really exciting.
Technology.
I like your happy birthday sign, Rachel.
Oh, thank you. Well, it's not mine. So I'm at my friend's house, my neighbor, my best friend, because our floors are getting sanded and I like set up everything. It's just funny. Her twins had a birthday not long ago. And so that's what the happy birthday is for. So it kind of works.
Yeah, it totally works. It's still your birthday, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm sure we're going to have people jumping on, but I'm going to go ahead and introduce Miss Rachel. And I totally forgot when I was getting the graphic ready. I was like, oh yeah, wait, that's not her name anymore. So anyway, you all know Rachel, but she is amazing at being authentic and like she's got like a silliness to her, but it's like super endearing. And she is very good about just being like bold and putting her personality out there. And I think a lot of us are not that way. Especially with reels. And so if you were on our Brock Johnson call, you know from a couple weeks ago, I think, that reels are where it's at. So if you want more engagement, but not even engagement, but if you want more followers, that is the way to get organic followers, just by posting reels. And they need to be somewhat related to your area, but also you can infuse some humor and if that's your personality and other things, but you can make them teachable. And Rachel's going to get into all that because she is much better at this than I am. And so I am a student tonight. I'm here to learn. And so I'm going to turn it over to Rachel and let her teach us all the things. So Rachel.
All right. So this might be really quick because I did a lot of screen recording. You can grab your phone when I am explaining or when I'm showing you, but I'll share my screen when it's time. I have a whole slideshow. I'm going to talk because I'd like for y'all to just see my face because sometimes slideshows are just boring and all I'm going to do is read what's on them. But they're for you for later. So I do want to touch on, if you didn't tune into the Brock Johnson call, I didn't, but I've listened to his podcast and I've found a couple of accounts that have really helped me, and I'll share who that is at the end. But I want to talk about why reels are so important. And if you're going to be putting in your energy, into video at all, for example, if you're doing stories, you need to be doing reels because reels are basically just repurposed stories and put in like a little more presentable way. And just to preface that, reels do not need to be another thing that you feel like you have to do and you have to dance or you have to do what's trending, because then you're just sort of a slave to whatever Instagram is now telling you to do. So it needs to be suitable to your personality. And I'll give you a lot of ideas on ways to do that because it can be very, very simple, like a recipe where you're not even showing your face. So, and that can be comfortable in your way to just learn the ropes with reels. And then, you're getting comfortable, hopefully talking behind the scenes in stories, sharing your personality, but then eventually you want to build up to reels. So number one is just engagement. It's the fastest way to get your point across because people really aren't reading. They're not going to read long posts unless they already have a relationship with you, which reels is going to help you build relationships faster. If you're showing your personality, it forces you to be concise. So we have 15 to 30 second reels now, and so you could say what you want to say in that amount of time versus writing a whole post like we used to, or you could even take an old post that you have written and make it a reel. So I kind of already touched on that. And the algorithm is just rewarding it. So it's like video, it's reels, then IGTV, then like high quality photos, and then like low quality photos. So I want to go over some do's and don'ts before you do it, because anything new, we always blow out of proportion, or we think it's harder than it is, and we have in our heads what it's going to be like. So just sort of telling you a couple, know exactly what you're going to share, because you can spend way too long just like going back and forth on that. So just write down some ideas. Hopefully this call will help. Think about what you need to hear, either right now or before Beachbody. Like, what do you need to hear? What are some simple tips? Write down your notes beforehand, just some aesthetics, record in natural lighting, reels, even beyond just reels getting seen more, the ones with natural lighting are going to be seen more, where there's a captivating picture or it's just a well-lit area. Use caption and visuals that are like from the very beginning. So like have a caption from the get-go, the first moment people open the screen, that's what they're going to see. So that needs to be a pretty good hook. I promise I'm going to go through tutorials too. Right now I'm just covering the bases here. Don't just copy a reel because it's trendy, unless it has a point and it's going to attract the type of person that you want. So if it's trendy and you're like, ooh, I could make that for like do's and don'ts for fitness, or I could make that like tie into what I want to talk about with my organizational habits, whatever it is. Don't, this is just, it's not necessarily a pet peeve of mine, but I've heard some of the experts say not to do a lip syncing reel unless you have it exactly right. So this is where it's unproductive or counterproductive if you're picking something that's too hard, doesn't have a point, and it's taking you forever to get it right. So kind of start with the simpler stuff, which I'm going to share, so that you're not just overexpending your energy and, you know, you're not getting the end result that you want. And lastly, don't copy other people's style or wording. You have to be yourself. You will 100% attract the right people if you are yourself. So just some quick common fears and questions. No, you don't have to dance. So you, again, that started with TikTok. And yes, the reels are mirroring TikTok. But like, really, there are so many other things. Like I watched my husband, Neil, go through all reels, and they were all like how-tos, behind the scenes, like intricate things, art, things that are like so not dance, right? In fact, now dance is sort of annoying, and I'm a dancer. I'm like, oh, cool. Okay, whatever, another dancer. unless it's like crazy cool or funny or, you know, something like that. There's some exceptions. What if I'm not good on video? Well, if you're not comfortable with video, you can use captions and music instead. So you could just like show your face and do an expression and like kind of do some clips like that and put captions on top of it. Or you don't have to show your face and you could show, you know, something around your house. Before and afters have been really popular. And we'll again, get into that in more detail. If you don't have enough stuff to share, you 100% do. That's all I have to say about that. You just need to have a brainstorming little power hour with yourself. Do I have to talk or show my face? So I kind of touched on that. Eventually you want to build up to that. But again, there are so many other ways to be of value and share even your personality without actually talking. So here are some real ideas. And again, I have this all on a cute little Canva presentation. So don't worry if you didn't get them all. So I have actually like 12. So three to five tips on XYZ. Like I have one that's like 3 to 5 tips to de-stress. I was actually going to do like I had like 10. I was like, why am I doing this? I can make this like a 4-parter. So like things that are just like so simple, maybe that's so simple to me, but I was like, people kind of need that. They need to hear that. Progress. So your before and afters, and we'll show how to share that if it's just pictures. But those are very captivating and people want to see that. Behind the scenes, how-tos, tutorials, quick wins. I really liked this one because this is what we've talked about in Beachbody many times before, getting your customers quick wins, getting your coaches quick wins. But in this case, you're getting your audience quick wins. So if you're sharing something with them that they can apply like in the next hour, they're going to come back to you. Or a life hack, just like something, hey, here's something you didn't know. Have you tried this? They're going to be like, hey, I remember that chick. I'm going to go back and see what else she's going to share because that was really helpful. So I loved that one. And for me, it makes me creative to think, what do I need? What quick win do I need right now today? And you know, obviously this is going to take some planning. It's not like you just think of it and you can just go right at it. But that is something that I feel like that could be like a once a week thing. Common misconceptions. You could talk about common coaching misconceptions, common challenge group misconceptions, dieting tip things, like just debunk some myths. Is that all right? Mythbusters? Yes. Or a quick story of relatability. So this is when I realized I had to be diving into reels because I'm a talker and I was talking on stories like almost every day, especially if you're reading PD, you got something to say. And I was like, why am I rambling on? First off, I can cut this down. I can be more concise. And two, I need to share this with the explore page versus just, you know, my small following. And it's even smaller than that because I think it's like, I don't know, 10% of my following that's actually watching my stories. So, you know, it's smarter. Like, yes, I'm still going to do stories, but if I said something, I was like, yeah, that was good. That like, I hope that encouraged someone because it encouraged me. So that's when you need to like put that together in a little package and put that in reels. So that's a quick story of relatability and you're just speaking to your ideal customer. I thought of this one. A lot of these I got from another chick. So these weren't all my ideas. I thought of this one. Have you ever done this? Are you this person? I thought of a really random one, which I don't know if I'm going to do this in reels, but have you ever, when you're in the shower and you don't want to get out, do you count down to yourself? So, because I do. I'm like, I'm not ready, but I can do it. 5, 4, and I do the 5-second rule because I don't want to get out. Anyway, I just thought that was so random. I might not do that on reels, but I just, you know, that's kind of funny stuff. Next thing is, it's not me, but it is definitely some people. I know Fern, I don't know if she's on this call, Fern Downs, she did a recipe and she shared how she was breaking down what she made and it was super cute. She added music to it and she didn't have to talk. And I know Devin did something similar and Devin shared her transformation. I'll share my transformation, reel with you guys. So those are good ideas, but recipes and cooking, like everybody wants to see that. I do, even though I won't make them. style ideas and home decor. I kind of pair those together. These are all just ideas. I like fashion, but I'm probably not going to share unless I got like a great deal on boots or something. But like, say you wanted that to be part of your brand, that's something you could share, or home decor. Right now, I'm like trying to do like organizational things to make your life easier, to like declutter, like just stuff like that. Favorite finds, preferably what you don't sell. And I know it's a given. Why wouldn't we talk about all the stuff we sell? But it builds a little more trustworthy that you're not just going to sell stuff. You're going to actually share other things too. I shared a before and after of like before pre-workout and after. I never did say energize, but you know, you can do stuff like that, but favorite finds or Friday favorites or Amazon favorites, those are really helpful. Like if you have something that has just been like so helpful to you, then definitely share that in a reel. And then last one would be fun facts. Something that's like, you know, pretty interesting, not because sometimes I'm like, fun facts, really? Here's a fun fact about me. But try to think of maybe something like that maybe someone else has experienced and can relate to you.
That wasn't fun at all.
Right. So now I'll share my just some examples. This is not to like toot my own horn because I'm really like, I've done like 7. But this is an example of how to apply it without it just being a dance. So I have 3 examples. Let me share my screen. Oh.
Let me make you a co-presenter.
Okay, okay.
Hold up. My girl Nicole taught me how to do this. So.
Hey, Nicole.
I gotta find your name. There you are.
Hey, you did the good one about sharing your coffee creamer.
I did?
Yeah, remember when you did in the stories? I don't think you made it a reel.
I didn't, and I need to.
It was a good one with your coffee creamer. That was a good find.
It was Fruity Pebbles, and that's probably not going to come around because it was their 20-year anniversary, so it was good. Okay, I'll share my
screen.
It was so good. Okay, desktop. Why isn't it letting me? I know I can do this. Oh, come on. Share screen. Can y'all see it?
Uh-uh. It says you're a co-host now.
I know, but now it's like, oh, I'm going to be so mad. I worked really hard to do this. Start share. Oh my gosh. Whew.
Okay.
Can you see it now?
No.
This is stressing me out. Come on.
Oh, there it is.
Okay. Whew. Oh, now we're on my Facebook content. All right. So I was going to go to present. Let me go ahead and do that. Hopefully sound is just fine. All right. So I'm going to play this. And this is a transformation of mine. I did use a popular sound. So that's something you could use is not necessarily picking trendy things, but trending sounds. And then use that on.
This, y'all. It's my hidden talent. Oh, you want me to do it again?
And then I just popped out. So there's that one. And then I took something that I posted on Facebook, at home workouts. You mean like Jane Fonda? And then that was a call to action. And that is, I screen recorded my phone and I went to my albums and I scrolled through the photos because Reels will not do photos. They will only do video. You have to make it a video. So you got to play with it. And again, I'll show you an exact tutorial of how to do that.
To feel more.
Oh gosh. I had to speed my voice
and
up.
Confident. Steps 1 and 2, fix your posture, pull your shoulders back, give yourself a smile. Step 3, drink 16 swigs of water. Step 4, deep breaths, 3 in, 3 out. Step 5, release some tension by moving your neck side to side, front and back.
And that was just, okay, so I know it's kind of silly, but I, that day I was just feeling so stressed. Like I felt like I couldn't get my shoulders like down. And so I was like, okay, how do I just like, get myself in the mood. And I remember Shalene Johnson had a podcast episode where she described it. And she's like, I need you to press your shoulders back. I need you to lift up. I need you like, and I did it with her and I felt so good. And so that's sort of what I was modeling there. And then I did go into a little bit more detail for the people who would read it. And this, so that was, if you can read it, you have to watch it. It goes by so fast. And now, thank goodness, there's 30-second reels because I had to fit that into 15 seconds. It was a tricky one. So basically, this is me talking about trying to lose weight again, trying to build a business again, or trying the business idea again. Like if you tried and failed, the inner dialogue. So that's me staring at my inner dialogue, doubting myself, and then be like, oh, yeah, okay, I can. So, anyway, these are entertaining to me. So if nothing else, I'm like, I'm having fun doing them. But it's days, you know, days like that where I'm just like, okay, maybe I just need to dress the part. I need to just get some pre-workout in, put on some Queen and like go. So that was my not feeling it to feeling it. And I did mention pre-workout in there. So at least they know that, you know, I'm taking something. So I hope this doesn't play automatically. Oh goodness, this is gonna go so fast. So it's a 2 minute or so, 2.5 minutes of me walking you through it. So like literally this is exactly what you're going to do. And I have it in text as well. So like, if you wanna look at the slide, I wrote down like, do this, do this, do this, do this. But basically when you open, when you open your screen, let me move y'all to down here. I don't know if y'all can see that, but I can. So when you go to Instagram, you're gonna click on that button and it'll give you the option to, you know, upload something, and you're gonna go down to Reels, and then it's gonna give you the option to change the length. And now I pretty much just do 15, or I do 30 seconds, because 15 is just seems too short, unless it's like a, I don't know, like just a really, really quick one, like what I did earlier. But now that I have the time, I want the extra time. So you're going to change that, change the amount if you want. Then you'll go and you'll upload what you want to put in. So this is another before and after. This is me in the morning when I'm not feeling it. And then this is, you know, once I get going, my workout. So literally those two things, if you're confused on that, you will not be when you are in Reels. Like it is just like if you were to upload a post or a video, it just goes to your reel. And then what it does is when you're done, so here, right here where you see the bar, I can shrink it down if I want to. This is where, you know, you have to be a little editing savvy, you know, and kind of play with that. But it's fairly simple. And then you're going to click add if you want that. So there's that. And then here's where you're going to trim. So those little scissors, that's what you're going to click on. And then here's where I trimmed it down, because I don't need to see my hot mess self that long. So I'm editing. Then I wanted to edit that. So I did that because I wanted to be, you know, that's where, oh, I'm sorry. So that's where you're going to add audio if you want to, which there should be some form of audio, right? So if you have a song in mind, or if you want to do a popular sound, this is something I did not share because I don't really have an example on hand, but let's say you saw a funny reel. It's the same thing if you are familiar with filters on stories. If you want that effect, you click on it and you save it. So like if you see that they use a funny little lip sync, whatever, and you click and you see their audio, you can click on that audio and you can save it too. The other way, a lot of people are doing it, and the way they get the original content is through TikTok. And I just hate TikTok. I just don't want to do it. So that's what I do. And otherwise I just pick a song that I like, or a trending song. So this one happens to be a trending song, and I was like, okay, maybe that'll work. This one's called Banjo, I think. So anyway, you'll see all the, and then I'm gonna, then you edit this. So you edit it just like you would, kind of like you would if you're putting music in your stories, if you have that option. And obviously I need to edit, so I'm gonna fast forward that. And then I edit it there. And now I'm tired of hearing the banjo. But you can see I got it to work. So then, wait for it. I'm gonna show you, sorry y'all, now it's just like getting on my nerves. I'm gonna show you where I add text. And I have a shortcut to this too, but here's how you wanna do it if you're doing it in the Reels app or feature, whatever. So this is my first caption. And I did that real quick. And then when you click here, so see how, I hope you can see it down below. There's a bar. This is where I have a shortcut around this, but I'm just explaining. I hope I'm not like overwhelming y'all too much. But where this happened, like I don't want this the whole video long, right? I want it to only be in the beginning. So then I just shrink it down and that caption will only show up in the beginning. So the caption has a length as well. So the audio has a length, the caption has a length, the video has a length. So if you want to shrink that down, you have to go there and mess with the bar. And sometimes it's necessary to do it within this app. And other times you can make it like you're making a story. And I'll show you that in a sec. So I did that. And then I just said, feeling it. And this is such a simple one, but there's other ones where it's like, you know, it pops up periodically and you really have to get specific. And then that's it. So then you go, that would just happen so fast. So just like you would, you go to that top corner and you save it. Like I always save it just because I'm like paranoid that I'll lose all my hard work. So I save, then I'll either share immediately or I'll save as a draft. Typically I'm doing it a little ahead of time. And then you also want it to share to your feed. And I'm going to tell you, you need to be purposeful about your cover photo. So I'll stop the share now. Well, no, hold on. I think I have one more I want to share. Shortcuts. I think that's it. So I'll stop sharing and just really briefly go over this. So if you are familiar with Instagram, this will make sense. So what you don't want to do is create, when you're looking at stories, the length is like longer than a square. But when you're looking at your feed, it's a square. So, I did screen share that. I did. Let me see. I'll share that with you. I hope I'm not going over too far on time.
No, you're fine.
Okay. Oh, dang it. You know what? I think I gave up on that screen share because it was bothering me. Screen record. So what you do is you open up, like you have the picture ready that you want to go on top of that as your cover photo. And you open up stories and you upload that picture to stories and you frame it to fit that. Like you shrink it, I could show you right now. Basically that way your whole picture is in that square and you're not like, oh man, like, cause I did that. And then it was all off balance and it just bothered me. Like, is it the end of the world? No, but is it good to know going in? Yes. So like you want the look. And also I like to add text either above or below. Like, so I'll add to my stories right now. I'm just going to do this little sweaty selfie here. So if I used it like reels, it'll go like right here. And I don't want that on my feed. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm looking, y'all are like on my right now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to shrink it down to where it could fit in that square to be on my feed. And then I might even do a caption on top, how to organize your day or whatever, or how to master your morning routine. Because what will happen is, and this is something I learned from Virginia Kerr, who's, I'll recommend her in a second. She said, people like reels are so popular. People will like your reels could be like revived from the dead, like wherever the graveyard is of Instagram. But like people could stumble on it again and then they'll find your account and they might look at all of your old reels and that will help seeing all those titles. And I know this because I did a deep dive in her reels and they were all very helpful. And I knew because of the titles. So if you're really taking this seriously and you are wanting to share and do this, then it's a really smart idea. So again, it is just a cover photo. But now you know. So making that fit on the square, you know, makes your feed look good. And then also you're sharing like what it is you're about to cover in that feed. So if you wanted to try it out right now, I can walk you through it. So you'd go like whip out your phone, open Instagram, go to the, now I'm in the wrong place. go to the plus sign, go at the very bottom, post, story, and then reels. And then if you swipe up, you can look at all of the videos within the last 24 hours that you've made. And you can just click on one. Just click on one and just for funsies. And then you'll see immediately, as soon as you pop it in, you're gonna see that little bar where you can adjust, right? You can adjust the length of that video, right? And then you click add on the very top. And you know, make sure you've checked the length, upload your videos, you know, click on the captions. So once you've got everything, if you see there's like a little, Hold on, sorry y'all. Once I'm done, so I'll just show you really quick. I wanna make sure I can be seen. So I'm doing a really like short one right now. There's nothing on mine, but there's a little arrow down here and I'm gonna click forward. So this is me in my robe before I work out because I'm cold. Me and my sister.
Probably, but where, how do you get to the text?
Oh, that's what I'm gonna show you. So you have to click this arrow once you've uploaded everything you wanna upload. And then you'll have text just like you will a story. And that's where you do text. But let me share, because this is, to me, just drastically easier for right now. If you are like, I need the captions for dummies, then what you need to do is open up your stories and do them previously. Like, adding the captions after the fact are annoying. They're annoying if you have a lot to say. So like, it's easier to me if you can do a few captions. Like, the only tricky thing is stories are 15 seconds long. So like, what I would personally do is try to make it really, really concise and have like 5 to 6 seconds worth of whatever it is you're trying to say, or like, this is particularly if you're talking, and then have your captions, and then have your captions beforehand as if you were just kind of summarizing what it is you're talking about, and then upload it. And then all you have to do is like put them together. That's a whole lot simpler than trying to add all these things. Cause, and it's doable. It's doable. I did this one. I'll show you really quick. This is where it's sort of necessary, cause you can't do it in stories. But again, it's like, it, you don't have to. So let me see if I can find it. It isn't a draft of mine. Because it was basically, well, I'll just describe it. It was all my thought bubbles. So it was like what I was thinking. It was like, oh, like what people think about diets. It's like, no soy, no gluten, no dairy, no sugar, you know, no fun, you know? And that was my point. And then it was me and Jenny Laurie, like going to town on like food. And so that was tricky. Again, it was more cumbersome than anything, but it's like, okay, it's just like, well, maybe you work up to that. But the better, more efficient, if you're like, I just gotta make this simple, then you wanna open up your stories and do it there. Or let's say you're doing a recipe and you're recording, like record it like for 3 seconds and then 3 seconds, but then put the caption on there in your stories. Just simplify it, because otherwise you'll be whittling down the captions every time and that just gets tricky in your fingers. It's just a lot. So then for slideshows, I already touched on this, but you will screen record your phone, you'll go to your photos, and you will start scrolling through the ones. It helps if they're in order. Like, that's the kind of tricky thing, is like, okay, it's not going to be exactly right. That will be something that you will have to edit in Reels. But that, to me, it's easier to edit video than it is the captions. That's just my experience. But it's possible. And if you wanted to, you could just get an album and like create a little folder in your phone and make sure they're all in order and just screen record and then share it. So that's how I did those before and afters of myself. And I already talked about cover photos, try it out. And then additional resources here. It's literally just this one chick I started following, and I binge watched all of her reels, and I was like, okay, I'm convinced. I'm going to do reels. That's it. I'm done. her name is Virginia Kerr. Actually, it's at This Is Virginia Kerr, K-E-R-R. And she has links to her YouTube as well. And it's also This Is Virginia Kerr. She's Southern, not like super Southern twang, but you know, she's in the South. So she's relatable. She's fun. But that's all I have. That I hope that was not too fast or overwhelming. But it's not as hard as you think. And this, the more you do it, it's easier. To me, the challenge is just getting the content ready and like being planned about it ahead of time. So there you go.
Do you guys have any questions for Rachel? Yeah, I learned a lot personally.
Yay!
I took notes. I just have to practice. I know myself, and I know it's going to take practice.
Yeah.
I do have a question, Rachel.
Yes.
So I can only get music. I can't get like when people talk and then they lip sync the people talking. Are they saving?
Yes, you have to save the sound. So you can't just like search it.
Okay.
Well, anytime you're watching somebody else's reel and you see like their sound thing, you just click on it just like you would a filter, and then you can save it.
Correct.
And then that will populate when once you have that, it'll like, you'll have the option to add that. And so
yeah. Let me see.
Not where that I'm gonna be like lip syncing.
Yeah, it should pop as a, like you. It'll pop up as say like okay, so at the top, right here, it'll be on my saved.
Oh, okay.
It already records what I've saved. So, and then some of them aren't, like I said, they're not songs. They're just little sounds or vocals. A little pop thing.
Awesome. Thank you.
That was so yeah. Helpful.
Yay. So everybody do a really good job. I totally tagged along with your puns in the entire slideshow. So I hope y'all enjoy that.
Hey, Rachel, one more question.
Yeah.
So I don't care. No, I'm sorry, Susan. What'd you say?
Oh, sorry. One more question. I mm-hmm. answered it, but so if you want one that where they're speaking and it's not a song, other than you see it on a reel and save it, where else do you find those?
TikTok. Or you could search it if you know exactly like you really might could search it, Luann, too. It because it is just audio. It doesn't say music. It says audio. So if you knew, like, I wouldn't have known to just look up banjo on that song, but it actually popped up as a popular sound. So that's the only reason I knew. So that might take some research. So that was something that I was sort of relieved because I was like, well, I don't want to have to use songs all the time. I'll just talk. So you're such a likable, like charismatic person. I think you should just do a lot of your speaking. Personally, because it is more like that is what people are gonna relate to. Not that you can't make funny ones, because pretty much all of those were funny. I didn't talk in any one of those. I sped myself up. But anyway, that's my suggestion first. And then like you will come across some and then you're like, ooh, I like that. And then just save it.
A couple of things. So we were having this discussion in the roundtable and about reels and who was seeing a lot of growth on their Instagram account because of reels and some tips that they were sharing that I will share with you really quickly. So to attract the right people, I mean, if you do like the funny stuff all the time, like it's not going to convert. So they're not going to become necessarily like your people who are going to be your challengers and your coaches and whatever. So while it's maybe okay to do occasionally, like you really want things that are within like your brand, but also like a little bit, like the best ones generally are like a little funny and within your brand. So you kind of want to not do things that are just like, oh, this was really funny, whatever. I mean, you might gain followers and new eyes on your page, but there's just not a lot of evidence so far that those convert to customers and coaches. And for me, like I don't care about followers if they're not going to convert. So I only want people who will convert. So that's one thing to consider. So think about like your message and like really what you're trying to say, and then stick mostly within that. I mean, have fun within, you know, I mean, you don't have to be like a one trick pony. I'm not saying that, like still within your brands, you can have like lots of different interests, but you want to make sure that, you know, you're still going to attract the people you want to attract. And so if you are just doing whatever's like trending or funny or whatever, you might not, just a lot of time, unless you just have a ton of time on your hands or whatever, but you know, it's a lot of time spent trying to create something for what purpose, you know, for what end, when you're not going to necessarily get the people who are your people or who are going to become your tribe, so to speak. So anyway, that was a really common thing. Some other ones were just, you know, just don't be afraid to just be silly. You can always delete them. And they were saying, like, you have the ones, a lot of people were saying the ones they thought were like awesome and hilarious and whatever, or just were like really good, like didn't get seen. And the ones they just like threw up went viral. And so you just never know. So just kind of don't judge them yourself, I guess. Don't prejudge. Just be like, do it more and more and more. And Brock Johnson was saying yesterday, I think, like once a day, one a day or something like that. So anyway, I think you can always delete it, right?
So, right. Yeah, I would pick whatever is good for you.
Terrible. And try. Just take it down. Do what?
Oh, sorry. I was just saying, pick whatever's comfortable to you. I was trying to do 2 a week just to get comfortable doing them. Yeah. So, and you know, you can always either delete or like archive them and take them off, mm-hmm. or take them off your feed, keep them when you take them off your feed at least. But it's good experience and it's really what's attracting.
Yeah, it definitely. I mean, definitely that's what's getting more eyes on your page. And so if that's your goal and you're just growing your account, then that's definitely the way to do it. Just don't be afraid, I guess. Speaking to myself too, because this is not what is comfortable for me. So
I have one more tip.
Yeah.
If you're gonna share a teaser in your stories, don't have the audio on and cover it up, because a story is 15 seconds and a reel is 15 seconds. So they can just watch it and there's no incentive to go to your post or to your feed. So have like, and it's at the top where like, so y'all know that you can share if you did a new post to your stories. So that's always what I do to pique interest, mm-hmm. and then mute that audio and then cover it up with like a new post, little GIF or whatever. And that way they're not just like, oh, well, I already saw it. So why do I need to go look at your feed?
Didn't even think about that. Good tip. All right. Any other questions from anyone? All right. Well, thank you so much, Rachel. I so appreciate your time.
And you're welcome.
Loved everything you shared. It was all, they were all things that I needed to know. So appreciate you.
All right. I'll share the slideshow as well.
Tonight, I will post the recording in Rate and see you guys later. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Thank you so much, Rachel.
You're welcome.